Number 15 0751736 0190. If this number texts you, do not text back. That's what many learned after being ripped off by this untrustworthy cell phone number. According to online reports claiming their friend or loved one has been hospitalized, the text comes from someone claiming to be Sarah, and Sarah has an urgent issue. She's broken a number of bones. The recipients are pushed to send money to help. Of course, this banks on the chance that the recipient knows someone by the name of Sarah, and if they do, they're likely to jump on board with worry. In full, the message says, "If it's possible, can you do me a favor? Had a stupid fall and broke my fibula and left wrist. Can you text me back when you get this text? Signal bad. Any attempt to call the number will come up short, but if you text, the number will respond, asking for phone credit." One recipient messaged Sarah back, asking the contact to answer her call, but the person on the other end responded that the signal was bad in the hospital. It seems in most cases, the person requests money in the form of phone credit. After sending the credit, the recipient received further texts requesting even more money. But of course, when they found the number of Sarah they believed was texting them, as it turns out, it wasn't the same number. Number 14. 777-888-999. According to a WhatsApp message, this number may just take your life. The urban legend WhatsApp message declares that if you answer a message from this number, you'll hear a woman on the other end. That's when your phone goes ablaze and you're likely to become another statistic of this cursed number. The message, which went viral, described the devastation of this cursed phone number. The result: thousands of WhatsApp users in total and utter terror. The message reads, "Dear WhatsApp users, please read the message carefully. It's not a joke. In between 12 a.m. to 3 a.m., don't pick up the phone call from the number 777-888-999. Yes, it's a 9-digit mobile number, but it's not fake. 10 people have passed away because of answering the call." The urban legend is particularly prevalent in India, where people in villages remained even more wary of answering this cursed phone number. The message has since been branded a hoax, but of course, that doesn't stop some from passing the urban legend along. And having gone viral, the false warning likely continues on. If you're a believer too, don't answer the message from this number. Number 13. Satanic WhatsApp message. What if a WhatsApp message were to possess you? According to one father in Peru, that's what happened to his two teenage daughters when they opened and read a piece of satanic chainmail. After the girls received the WhatsApp text message, their father found them both babbling incoherently early that morning. They were quickly transported to the hospital, where doctors said they were hysterical. The incident was recorded, with the video clip showing the girls lying on the floor in their pajamas, emitting awful noises, alternating between mumbles and high-pitched screeches. Medics tried to calm one of the sisters down on the way to the hospital, but when they arrived, they were still in a state of possession. Whatever you do, do not open satanic chainmail in WhatsApp, or you could be the next one possessed. Number 12. Stranger. After a woman got a package in the mail from a stranger, things got even weirder when she started receiving text messages from the person who sent the package. What was inside? A $982 money order and a letter, which the recipient, Diane Sanders, believed to be a scam. She sent photographs of the package contents into Channel 2 Action News via the news station's Facebook page. According to Sanders, it wasn't the package that bothered her so much, but rather the text messages that followed. When she read the letter that accompanied the money order, Sanders started to see red flags. According to the letter, if she deposited the money order and bought iTunes gift cards with the cash, she could keep whatever money remained if she sent the gift card serial numbers to the anonymous person. In other words, she'll have been ripped off. Once Sanders received the strange package, the anonymous person started texting her insistently, prompting her to begin her assignment. Sanders said not knowing how these people found her number was what really frightened her. She eventually called up the number and asked the man who answered if he was ripping her off. Of course, he replied in the negative. Thankfully, this particular recipient didn't take the anonymous person at his word. But if you're particularly vulnerable, it's best to avoid calling or texting the person back. They can be highly persuasive. Number 11, 10 million. According to an urban legend in Asia, this number, or a variation of this number, without one at the beginning, is a line to the passed away. A call or text from this number means that a dearly departed loved one is trying to contact you. Some claim to have received this call with only static on the other end. A call to this number, as the legend goes, will connect you to a male voice, which orders you to phone up 15 people and have them call the number 2. If you don't, of course, you pass away, very much like chainmail. There's no telling if the curse is actually real, although I would assume there'd be more unexplained and unexpected passings connected to the legend if it were real. But if I were you, I wouldn't try my luck. Number 10, Momo. What happens when you text back a haunted number? I'll let Momo explain. Momo is a nightmarish figure with enormous bulging eyes, long black The Ring-style hair, a too wide smile, and best for last, bird legs. She's the image you supposedly receive if you message this disturbing WhatsApp number. The whole urban legend started on August 25th, 2016. That's when Instagrammer Nanako uploaded a photograph of the figure, alleging that the image was sent by a WhatsApp number. More images of the figure were posted, and it was later discovered that Momo was made by Link Factory. Spanish-speaking WhatsApp users began claiming that a phone number that could be added to WhatsApp could send you disturbing pictures of Momo without warning. This terrified users who received the photos because of how scary Momo is. But why was this anonymous person sending these photos around? The answer to that question remains unsolved. Number 9, the past. Well, it's a little eerie to receive a text message from a stranger. It's even more spine-tingling to receive one from the past. In 2017, some mobile users said they received a text from a random number with nothing but a blank message. That's not the strangest part, though. The text came from 14 years in the past, all the way back to 2003. According to the date on the messages, recipients of these odd text messages began sharing screenshots of them to social media. SJ Williams wrote on Twitter, "Should I be concerned that I just received a blank text message from 2003? Anyone able to shed any light on this?" Some said they received the text from the phone number 19, which we all know isn't even close to a full phone number. Well, this mysterious blank message may have some thinking they were the result of a curse. Others believe there's some conspiracy going on, maybe even time travel. Some claimed it was the recipient's past self trying to communicate something to the future. Others thought it was probably the CIA hacking user phones. No big deal. More likely, the blank messages are simply a network glitch. Or it could be hackers. One user said hackers can fake absolutely everything about an SMS. In that case, do not reply. Instead, contact your network provider and let them know what just went down. Number 8, 801-820-0263, often reported as unknown caller 11317. Some claim answering this phone number results in creepy noises and sometimes even worse. According to Savannah, Courtney, Jasmine, Maddie, Christina, and Lindsay, the group of friends messaged the number on June 2017. In their own words, this is what happened. At 2:15 a.m., my friends and I decided to call some creepy phone numbers, which I regret doing now, and we found this number on a particular website. And we called the number on my phone. We heard very strange noises, and we heard 1-7, then a loud scream or something like that, and my friends yelled at me to hang up the phone, which I did. Confused and frightened by what happened, the girls were surprised to see the number call them back about 45 minutes later. One of the girls answered, and allegedly, the person said he was watching the girls. He spoke all their names and knew what they were doing in that given moment. Needless to say, the girls never again called or messaged the number. Others replied that they'd heard the same on the other end when messaging this number. They believed it was an audio recording because he'd called the number several times and received the same message. This individual did not receive a call back. Number 7, 858-651-5050. Well, this one isn't freaky once you know why it was created. Contacting it out of context might just send a chill down your spine. Serve the hot rum to the tired heroes. You'll hear on the other end, fishing in a mountain stream is my idea of a good time. Why such random phrases? Is this poetry or just some creep trying to confuse callers? It's neither, actually. Instead, these sentences were specifically designed to express the phonetically balanced nuances of speech that should be audible regardless of the audio conditions of your phone. Known as the Harvard sentences, these phrases were testing various audio for communication. The researchers were honing the simple, short sentences to indicate which sounds might be misheard if audio conditions were subpar. That doesn't explain why these sentences are readily available when dialing this number. Some say it's to test the quality of your cell phone, and phone companies use them to improve service, or perhaps in dialing this number. You become subject 1 to the Harvard experiment. It wouldn't be unheard of. Number 6, Boy by Bot. Have you ever been approached by a creepy person asking for your number? Well, you don't want to give them your real number. Producing nothing might come off as rude in the moment, and maybe you're even worried about what the person might do if you refuse. Enter Boy by Bot, the number 1-626-466-3293 or 1-626-GOODBYE will keep the creeps at bay. Unlike similar phone numbers, like the rejection hotline from 2002, Boy by Bot provides a text feature. When the rejected creepo texts the number, rather than receiving a flat-out rejection, they'll receive an increasingly erratic series of texts from a psycho chatbot. What kind of responses does your replacement provide? The chatbot will respond to the person with circular logic, links to Jezebel articles, off-the-wall questions, and other irrelevant replies that will send the person running for the hills. So if you ever get this number, don't text it, or you'll end up in a scary chat with a chatbot. Number 5, 845-354-9912. Well, this number may not be cursed or haunted. If it's not, then what in the world is going on with it? Discovered on Moo.net, when you dial this number, you hear a fairly standard message informing you that this call cannot be completed as dialed. However, not only is the message fading in and out like a horror movie, it's also spoken at a speed that's around 25% faster than the norm.
We're sorry, this is an unsolicited carrier. This call cannot be completed as dialed. You may designate carriers to handle this type of call by calling that company, or you've arrived in business office during regular business hours. To place this call in an emergency, just dial 0. We're sorry, this is an unsolicited carrier. This call cannot be completed as dialed.
Number 4, your own phone number. We've talked a lot about spoofed numbers on this list. Most calls come from strange, unknown numbers, but what do you do if your own phone number appears on your caller ID or in your messages? The correct answer is do not respond. Those who have claim to have fallen prey to providing personal information to the caller. Here's how this one goes. When the recipient of the call sees their own number on their caller ID, they're immediately curious as to why it would appear to be that they're calling themselves. When they answer, of course, they're not talking to themselves, but rather to a scammer. The person often already has the individual's name and number, and the call is done again through number spoofing. One female recipient, Kira Milk, said, I answered and they said, hey, this is so-and-so from the phone company, and I'm just calling to tell you that your account has been hacked. And I want to verify a few things with you to let you know. A warning from the Better Business Bureau. Consumers, they say, often fall for it, considering its simple strategy. So don't pick up a call that appears to have been dialed from your own phone number. In this case, it might just get your identity taken. Number 3. 844-395-2509. Type scam numbers into Google, and you'll find boards and pages filled with numbers. This one in particular is one of those fake tech support companies that are after your personal info and credit card number. What they do is lock your PC, usually via a pop-up indicating that you must message the so-called Microsoft or Apple support at this number to unlock it. Often, you can't click out of the pop-up without their help. If you do message them, however, they quickly unlock it for you and claim that there's a virus on your computer. They offer to remotely remove the virus and offer tech support, often quoting outrageous prices to do so. Once you've given them your account information, they basically do nothing to your computer, but they do something to your bank account. They collect on the fake service they've provided. Don't call or message these numbers back. The operators are usually very convincing. They do this for a living. There are some pages devoted to trolling these fake tech support companies. In that case, dialing this number is worthwhile. Number 2. Coded voicemail. Twitter users have reported receiving an eerie voicemail message with military codes. The voicemail message is said to consist of a robotic voice projecting a coded message in NATO phonetic alphabet. The message, recipients say, sounds automated. Decoding the message reads, S danger, SOS. It is dire for you to evacuate. Be caution. They are not human. 042-933-964-230. SOS, danger, SOS.
Sierra, Delta, Alpha. November, Golf, Echo, Romeo, Sierra, Oscar, Sierra.
The Malaysia flight theory seems to be one that sticks. According to Online Sleuths, when typed into Google Maps, the numbers may be applied as a set of coordinates, the locations of which include Africa and a spot near Malaysia, approximately where the 2014 flight disappeared off the map. Some speculate that this must mean something. Did the plane meet its end for some preordained reason? Was this voicemail a recording of the SOS event? The originator seems to be just your average Twitter user. Ty is his name, and his Twitter history is nothing out of the ordinary. That is, until he posted the alleged voicemail message to Twitter, asking for assistance in deciphering the code. The tweet took off. And after Ty had shared the message on Twitter, he claims he received several direct messages, some in Morse code, others warning from Indonesia and Malaysia, telling him to delete the post of the voicemail recording. The Morse code, which appeared in the following series of number sequences, translated to, they are taking over 20.8.5.25, 1.18.5, 20.1.11.9.14.7, 15.22.5.18, 41818, with the date April 18th, 2018 as the alleged day of reckoning. Prior to receiving the direct messages, Ty said a stranger drove past at 3 a.m. and photographed his home using a flash. He believes the direct messages, voicemail, and this stranger are somehow connected. Several other Twitter users presented their own voicemails after Ty came forward, some of which are identical to Ty's. This whole thing might simply be part of an online cicada-like puzzle, as a tweet by Lunar Rabbit seems to suggest. The account tweeted a message claiming that April 18th is definitely safe and that the event is for an upcoming global cicada puzzle. In their own words, the reason to hold this event is to aware people with knowledge. Well, that clears everything up. Still, if you get contacted by someone with a message like this, do not call or text them back. You may not know what you're getting into. Before we get to number one, my name is Chills and I hope you're enjoying my narration. If you're curious about what I look like in real life, then go to my Instagram at DylanIsChillinYT and tap that follow button to find out. I recently released a music video for my song Sidelined, and I'd love to get your opinion on it. Tap the circle icon in the top right corner, then tap my music video to give it a watch. It's also linked in the description below. It's a proven fact that generosity makes you a happier person, so if you're generous enough to hit that subscribe button and the bell beside it, then thank you. This way, you'll be notified of the new video we upload every Tuesday. Number 1. The FBI. If the FBI calls or messages you, unless you have a reason to believe you're under investigation, it's probably fraudulent. One author, Christian Baller, wrote in February of this year about how she received a series of calls from a number she didn't recognize, all of them over the course of 3 minutes. She avoided answering to begin with, but urgency grew when she received 5 calls, one after the other. When she Googled the number, she found that it was that of a local police station. Thinking that perhaps someone needed her or she was being called to point someone out in a lineup, she returned the call. It brought her to Manhattan's 24th Precinct switchboard. While she was listening to the extensions, she received another call from the precinct. When she answered, the individual on the other end asked if she knew that she was the subject of an FBI investigation. The individual asked if Kristen had been briefed and claimed that if she didn't comply, she'd be arrested. Luckily, Kristen wasn't going to fall for this scam that easily. She asked the caller for more information, and things got a little heated during the brief conversation, after which the so-called federal agent hung up on her. After being rejected, Kristen was left to wonder what this person had been trying to get out of her, and how the call could have possibly come from the police station. Kristen looked into the call herself, getting through to an investigator at the NYC Police Department switchboard, who couldn't help her, as there was no record of any investigation, nor did he know why or how the call had come from this number. But she wasn't going to let the issue drop there. She contacted Paige Hansen, an identity education lead at the cybersecurity firm that makes Norton antivirus software, who told her that this scam is not uncommon and is called spoofing. Using fake IP addresses and various techniques, the scammers can pretend to be calling or emailing from just about anywhere, even your local police station. If you think the call might be legitimate, do as Kristen did and call or text the real number back and make some inquiries. It's better to be on the safe side. Thanks for checking out this video. Be sure to subscribe because we upload new countdowns every Tuesday and Saturday. Or if you're still not convinced, here are some of our other videos that I think you'd like. Enjoy!